Okay, this video is another one of our basic four tarp configurations, the Uncivilized Vitality. This one we call the cave. Again, probably lots of different names for it. It's a pretty simple configuration to set up. You'll need 5 stakes, a short piece, maybe 6 feet of cord, about a 4-foot to 3-foot, depending on the size of your tarp, stick or a trekking pole you can use. So, and then some flat ground. So this is a good tarp to set up when you don't have an anchor point, two to run a ridge line, or even a single anchor point when you're going to run the wedge. The other benefit to the cave is it works well with a bug net. We'll show you that in another video. And it works well when the weather is really, really coming down and you don't want a lot of open space. So this will enclose you the most. This is a good one for winter. So to do this, you're going to, first of all, set your tarp out in a square. This is a 10 by 10, 10 foot by 10 foot free soldier tarp, which is basically the cheap version of a good DD 3 by 3 meter tarp, but it's got all the grommets and tie outs. Stake out your rear corner square, and that's going to be our front. So we're going to do here is we're going to take our stake, we're going to go to the outside corner grommet. We'll make sure the tent's nice and the tarp is nice and tight. And then where the second grommet is located, I'm going to move my first grommet in to where that second one was. Okay. Now run that stake down into the frozen Michigan early spring ground, although technically it's winter for another week. I'm going to do the same thing over here. I'm going to bring this outside grommet in to the approximate location of the second grommet. Stake that down nice and tight. Now, I'm gonna take my my prop, my trekking pole or my stick, and this is kind of important. I just quickly crowned off the edge to get rid of any sharp parts on the stick so it doesn't puncture my tarp. Sometimes you can throw an extra cup upside down or the bottom of a plastic bottle, or for expediency's sake, if I don't have a trekking pole and I decide to run a cave, I usually would just put one of my pocket morigamis kind of over that to pad my tarp. So I'm going to find that center line, the ridge line, and I'm going to go into about where that, again, the second grommet location is. And I'm going to stand my pole up in the center of that tarp. And in order to keep that pole up somewhat, we have to put some tension on it. We're going to find this peak grommet again. Run the grommet through that little loop in the end of our... You tie, there's an angler's loop there. You can tie a bowline, any kind of loop. We'll see if this toggle holds. All right. So I have that tight. Then I'm just going to run out here a little ways. Run that down into the gravel. Okay. And around this far stake, we're just gonna run another knot, hopefully you recognize. I'm gonna run one more time just because it's kind of slippery out today. So you run your taut line hitch. Okay. Tighten it up, slide that barrel up to put some tension on that line. Okay. And then I've seen, this is actually a pretty good trick. I can't remember where I saw this, but someone had used on the secondary grommet out here, had used a little bit of elastic cord to tie this back to another stake on the outside and see if the wind cooperates. So I can set those back along the outside to open up the mouth of my cave. One of the benefits of having this loose part in the front for weather protection for the cave is that I'll just tie these off with another bit of cord or just run a toggle between the two once I'm inside, and now I've buttoned this up pretty good for wind protection all the way around. And if you see if we can get a look inside. Once we get past that pole, there's plenty of room for one person to lay down in here, right? I've even got room and enough ventilation with the edges up, I could sit in here and maybe use a a jet boil or a small one of those quick propane stoves to heat some water, or maybe do that in the vestibule, the opening area there for the ventilation. But I could, if the weather is really inclement, I could stake these down further, really button this thing up. plenty of room in here for two adults to sleep side by side by the pole. You can use the pole to tie off a headlamp or something. Lots of variations and adaptations you can make to the cave, but this is the basic configuration. Five stakes and a 4-foot stick, a little bit of cord. So that's the cave. If you like this video, give that a try at home. Check out some of your variations. Let us know in the comments below if you come up with any kind of interesting adaptations or variations on the cave.